Hey everyone. Yesterday I made a little mistake. I forgot to record the stream. So now that everything is still fresh in my memory, I'm going to do a short recap of what happened previous session for you viewers so you guys know at least the gist of it. We left last session in the laboratory of Meridordron. She arrived. The fight itself against her was quite easy because she's just a Solar. After that, she was destroyed and the fire stopped spreading. And she basically, on the screen, you had this like downloading and installing, and then I made the joke about it being stuck on 99%. When she arrived back and they explained what was going on, she was utterly disappointed in her creations because when the angels get reset, they actually lose a part of their memory, like from the point that they were saved up. And she wanted to destroy all her inventions and start anew. Chaperone tried to talk her out of it, but that was an utter failure. And at some point, she just was done with it, and she started banging her head against the big red button so that more explosions would be caused and the Techno Pyramid was destroyed. In that process, Chaperone managed to take three floppy disks with the designs of the tank, helicopter, and the turret. Only thing is, he doesn't have a device that can read floppy disks, but that's about it. Then they arrived back at the main courtyard. I lost a map to that. It's still somewhere in the archives, but there's like 142 things, so I couldn't find it. There, a holographic Meridordron was there, and they sorry, I still have a cough. And they had a short conversation with the middle angel. Meridordron did not know what the other angel was. They decided to continue on to Mikaela. That was here. They had to fight her in a ice prison. She had a reaction. She had an added ability that she had a reaction to basically cost shield, but instead of +5, her shield gave her a +10 to AC, and it completely covered her in ice. She had a lair action that threw basically blizzards at random players. And the random players were saved themselves from the blizzard, but when the next lair action went off, everyone around them would freeze, and they would basically be out of the combat until they take X amount of damage. But Solars aren't that powerful compared to level 19 characters, and they basically beat Mikaela before he actually was a threat. Then they took a short rest back at the thing where also a holographic Mikaela arrived. There, the conversation became a bit suspicious with the was it? Madrisa, yeah. Madrisa. Because Mikaela also didn't know about that, and they started to distrust Marisa. They rolled a good insight check and discovered that Marisa was lying. And discovered that it was a holographic figure of the old god Yugalash. I then took a short rest and went for the plant one next, Mazeen. Now, what happened with Mazeen was also that they had a pretty easy job, only it was pretty annoying. What happened was that Mazeen has a lot of healing abilities. Basically, her lair action summons either a treant or an awakened tree to help fight her and completely heals her. So they basically had to do 243 damage before she could heal herself completely back to full again. And on her action, she could do that as well. So she healed herself completely up to full 3 times in a row until they got some lucky shots and took her down before her turn started. They also got very close a couple of times, like Eivor breathed on her with the Ring of Power, so that was like 156 damage, which you can see here, 243 hit points. Yeah, that's a big chunk. Luckily for me, or unluckily for them, they missed a lot. Now, almost forgot to say, the angels also gave buffs. Mavedron gave everyone an intellect buff permanent. Michaela gave everyone a constitution buff permanently. That was present. This was also for the followers. But if the followers weren't present, they wouldn't get anything. So, for example, Sol, because he got disintegrated last session, did not get any of the intellect buffs or anything. Then Mazeen gave a wisdom buff to everyone except for Chaperone, because Chaperone was very mean to her. Then they went for the combat one, Mavedron. There, they actually just sent Tobias in by himself with Devourer, Poison, and everything. But there was this plan for an arena fight where they would get in here and then constantly gladiators would show up to challenge them. And when they've beaten enough gladiators, they were allowed to go through this door, fight the blue dragon, avoid the slimes here while new gladiators spawn. And also fight Jubilex before they could fight Mavedron. But they circumvented that by Tobias sneaking in invisibly in here, opening this door, then coming in here. Got caught by the blue dragon, but and had to fight the blue dragon, but had enough good enough initiative to use his Spectre form to go from here into here. And there he got a super surprise sneak attack on Mavedron and defeated her in one blow because he did like 500 damage or something. Because assassin. Because Tobias was the only one there, he was the only one that got the blessing from Mavedron, which was a +2 to strength and a +2 to dexterity. And then they gathered up back at the main thing. They resurrected Sol, I believe, and went into the prison of the old god. The fight started at the start with four random minions. I rolled a d10, and then here you have the list of minions. So things showed up. It was two demi-liches, a vampire, and a lich. Not something to be really worried about. Then I believe a super zombie and a dragon lich, a draco lich, also showed up until Yugalash himself showed up. They were lucky on and then during the lair action, what I did was I rolled every time a d20 to see if any of the things spawned. If it was a 11 or higher, none would show up, but if it was a 1 till 10, it would have been one of these enemies. What they did is that they did all their summon things, and what they did was they used the cannons to put Yugalash in a squeezed position where they could get advantage. And that's how they took him down, because they constantly had advantage to attack him. At that point, I had to make the call that Yugalash was going to target the weaker enemies so that he had an escape route so that he could be stand normally again. One thing that they discovered with Yugalash was that he had unlimited legendary actions. They did manage to beat Yugalash quite easily. It wasn't in the danger zone or any form. And when they beat him and he died with Tobias's God Killer Dagger, because that was like, even if they like, if one of the other characters did kill Yugalash, yes, Yugalash would have been dead and that threat was finished. But Malitor could not leave his prison until one of his weapons killed Yugalash. So they had to try and find a different way to how do you call it? To get into the Shadowfell if they wanted to ask the Dark Sun for help. With Yugalash defeated, the Mistress of Death actually gained an extra aspect of Undeath, because that was Yugalash's main thing. So now she is the Master of Death and Undeath. And that doesn't necessarily mean that she became evil, because it could also, you could also be like a helpful spirit or something like that, or reincarnation or all sorts of things like that. That's also necromancy and undeath. And she became more powerful because of that, and then their reward was that they got an extra one of the super boons that I made for the death boons. After that, they went to Malitor, who needed a day to build the key to the Shadowfell. So they took a long rest, got their shit together. They've noticed that Australia was also a lot less gloomy and dark than it was before. Things were brightening up because Yugalash was the one that was corrupting the land. And so, yeah, we left off with them taking a long rest. I probably forgot some important details in the game, but that is about it. Next session, after they finish their long rest, the key will be finished and they will go to the Dark Sun. Which many, which the other gods and many other creatures have said will be the hardest to convince. I'm not actually sure, because they could roll a bunch of natural 20s and problem solved. But we will see how the Dark Sun fares, or how they will fare. That was this session, or at least the recap of this session. I probably forgot some details, but that's the gist of it for the most part. I hope you all enjoyed it, and I hope I do not make this mistake again.